Hey, I'm Reverend Jonathan Reed, the proud youth pastor of the Christian Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church, located in Memphis, Tennessee, 1365 Fairfax, where my pastor is Pastor Anthony Holloway. We thank you for tuning in to this great website that you have chosen on YouTube, and we hope that you enjoy the message where I brought at True Love Missionary Baptist Church, located in Memphis, Tennessee, which is entitled, I Need a Makeover. We hope you enjoy. Hope that you hear a word from the Lord. Be blessed.
Amen. We have one honest person out there that says she needs to be in Bible study. Amen. That's all right. Psalms 51, verses 1, 2, and 3 reads as follows. It says, have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sins. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sins is ever before me. I want to talk on this particular thought today. I need a makeover. I need a makeover. And it's not too cute this morning. It's not too good morning. Just turn around to neighbor and say, neighbor, I need a makeover. And that comes to the other neighbors and say, neighbor, you need a makeover. A makeover. I need this morning a makeover. I need a makeover. And the reason why I'm called to say it is because it's a personal thing. I need a makeover. Sister Pierce, I need a makeover. My brothers and sisters, this morning, I've discovered that CoverGirl has a whole lot of mascara. Well, a lot of women can put on their face when they don't feel like when they have something wrong with their faces. To cover up the little spots and wrinkles and to cover up all of the scratches they have. CoverGirl this morning has a way of giving you a makeover when you have a lot of bruises on your body. But this makeover that I'm talking about this morning is a spiritual makeover. Because we have a lot of folk in church. Talk back to them if you can. We have a lot of folk in church that have a lot of nasty attitudes. We have a lot of folk in church that has a lot of envy, a lot of jealousy in their heart, and they need a spiritual makeover. So we have a lot of folk that are trying to look good on the outside, but so jacked up on the inside. We have a lot of folk that are trying to make folk proud, but not trying to get the inside of them correct. Somebody. We have a lot of folk in church that have a lot of hatred, jealousy, envy, and jealous towards one another. But then again, say that you love God, who you've never seen. Talk back to somebody. But you say you love your brothers and sisters, but you hate your brothers and sisters that you walk with. Baby, we need a makeover this morning.
David had messed up because it was in the springtime when they were in war, but David stayed.
there. Acts 1:41, he stayed behind. But the Bible says that one morning, David woke up and looked out on the balcony. And the Bible says he saw a beautiful woman. Now, let me put it to today's term. Maybe he saw a body like Beyonce, a face like Trina, or a pretty the face sticking y'all in like y'all been saying all your life. But he probably found somebody that was pretty the face sticking the way. And David told one of his servants, I want you to go down and find out who she is. And when the word got back to David and said, she is the daughter of Gideon. She is the wife of Uriah the Hittite. But by David being king and by him having his power and authority, he let his power and authority overrule him. And he said, I want her to come up to my room and we're going to have sex with each other. Y'all deep on this end. Let me talk to the preachers back here. Y'all acting so deep this morning. And so he said, I want to sleep with her. You found yourself sometimes creeping in somebody else's bedroom. You found yourself this morning and Johnny came up there tiptoeing in the bedroom. You found yourself being Johnny on the spot this morning. You found yourself going into the hole in the wall. You found yourself doing some things that you're supposed to do. Talk that trip to somebody. You found yourself looking at another man's woman. You found yourself looking at another woman's man. I think I'm a preacher here. So David, by his power and authority, we see that David has said, I will sleep with this woman. And you know what happened? David ended up getting the woman pregnant. That's on the 2 Samuel, the 11th chapter. I know what I'm talking about, just in case some of you are looking lost. But I'm going to come get you in just a moment. Just stay with me as I take the picture. Just stay with me. So we see, when we see that David had ended up getting the woman pregnant. Now, David knew the woman was married. And see, a lot of us, some of you all have got caught up in your own mess now, because that's what happened to David. Because David, found out we got a pregnant, he's so married. To Joab to send you around your home. Now I'm going to tell you how the devil always try to play tricks, on other folks. The devil knows what happened. By him being king, he tried to get him drunk. He tried to get him to go back home to sleep with his wife. But it was one time he didn't go back home. Every time the king sent him home, he went out to sleep with the guards. But was gone the palace. Talk back to me, somebody. And so, by him seeing that Uriah didn't go back home, David ended up giving in a way not a death certificate for Uriah. Yeah. And you know who he sent the death certificate by? He sent it by Uriah himself. And by the way, I want you to know that sometimes folks are so cold-hearted and cruel, they'll do anything to mess other folks up, even though nobody ain't bothered them. Talk back to me, somebody. You know some cold-hearted folks. Some folks that's trying to mess you up because of what they see in, how jacked up their life is. Tell somebody, I don't play that mess. Joe was trying to take me out for something that he'll need. Talk back to me, somebody. Trying to use me for a crutch and trying to cover up his own mess. Because that's what he tried to do, to cover up his own mess.